teddy bear. The Squid Game players are going for the Dalgona Honeycomb Candy Challenge. Hello, Zippy. There are four shapes to choose from. Triangle, star, circle, and the umbrella shape. Which shape would you choose, Teddy? I'll definitely pick the umbrella shape. It is so pretty. It reminds me of the time when I had fun playing in the rain. Mom was really upset that I got my clothes dirty. I like the circle shape. It looks like my papa's belly, round and smooth. The circle is kind of boring. It is just round. I think the umbrella is the best shape ever. Not really. All my favorite foods are round, like my favorite candy, banana pancake, cheeseburger, pizza. Yummy! Well, I get it. Those are my favorites too. But the main question is, which shape is the easiest to carve in order to win the honeycomb challenge? Why don't we use data science to predict the results? Isn't there something called survival analysis? Do you mean time to event analysis, Zippy? We can use this method to find out the time for a group of individuals to experience an event of interest. That sounds about right, Teddy Bear. There are four shapes, and so there can be four groups of players. Yeah, Zippy. And the event of interest will be dead or alive. If a player is successful in carving out their shape, they will then stay alive. If not, they will be eliminated.
One hour remaining. Those who are unable to remove their shapes from their honeycombs will be eliminated. Player 147 is eliminated. Minutes remaining.
Let's hurry up, Teddy. Let's find out which shape is the easiest. Okay, don't worry. We can use the Kaplan-Meier estimate to measure the fraction of players who survived for a certain amount of time. This is to show the average view of the population. We can define survival time as the time starting from the beginning of the honeycomb challenge to the occurrence of the event of interest. Players either survive or die. To start, why don't you install RStudio, Zippy? Copy that. Installing. Done! Now, let's install two packages, SurfMiner and Survival. Okay, let me Google. Loading, and done! Now, you can bring in your dataset, Zippy. Got it! This dataset has four columns. Player number, shapes, dead or alive outcome, and time to the end of the game in minutes. That's right. You can then use the SurfFit function to calculate an estimate of a survival curve. Copy that. Then, I can use the ggSurfPlot function to generate a graph. Yes, try that. Plotting, and done. So, there are four lines on the survival graph. That means those lines represent the four shapes. That's correct, Zippy. we can see that players who selected the star shape have the highest chance of surviving and winning the game. The umbrella shape doesn't look good, Teddy. Yeah, Zippy. Based on this analysis, players who chose the umbrella shape are more likely to be eliminated.
Player 1, pass. Please proceed to the main entrance and collect your prize. Player 66 is eliminated.
What is player 456 doing, Teddy? Is he trying to eat the honeycomb? I'm not too sure, but it looks like he's able to slowly dissolve the candy. Yeah, I think his technique is working.
Player 456, pass. Please proceed to the main entrance and collect your prize.
Thanks for teaching me the time to event analysis, Teddy Bear. I'll choose the star shape then.
Good choice. Good luck.
Teddy, is that you? Teddy?